Welcome everybody, you're watching Mr. Fugu Data Science. Today we will use Python and Postgres, featuring the extract function of Postgres and Seaborn for plotting. As always, the code will be linked in the description below. The outcome and purpose today will be to create a table with the extract function where we're taking a date column and extracting the month and year. And we're going to get the quantities of items that were sold by month and year. Then we're going to use a bar chart from Seaborn and create a nested bar chart. Now, I will not go over the creation of the init and config files today. If you'd like to see those, you should look at the description link above, it'll pop up. If you are not worried about hiding any of your credentials or do not have any credentials, I would suggest using this generic form and trying whatever database you're logging into and then your username. Okay? So, we need to do some imports. We need to import psycopg2, pandas, calendar, matplotlib, seaborn, and here I'm calling in my config file with the specific function that I'm using for my parameters, where my config file stores my parameters as key value pairs. But for you, you could just do above if you're uninterested in this. Now, we're making our connection, and then we're creating a cursor. And this cursor is allowing us to interface and send data or run queries with our database. I'm using auto commit equals true here because I want every operation that I do to happen now. We have two data sets that are used, which are our user information such as credit card, email, first and last name, and their primary phone number. The second will be what they purchased on that credit card and the data was purchased. In our last video, which will be also described above, will dictate how we did a join between the credit cards to create the file we will use today. Now, we will look real quick at what a basic query looks like of our data that was joined. I printed out two entries right here. It's the credit card, the email, the first name, last name, phone, what they purchased as a CPU, and what date. So let's get into running a query on these data. It's kind of big, so bear with me and let's try to pay attention. So we need to select and then say extract our year from the purchase date column, and then alias as year. Okay, well that's perfect. Now you just can copy or type it again and just say do this for month, alias is month, and then we'll hit a comma and say count everything from what table. We're doing the staging fake CPU purchases, and we need to group by our year and the month. Okay, then you do the simple cursor execute as always, and instead of printing out our query, we're going to create a data frame. So we're going to say sales by month and year, and then append a data frame. And then here, you're going to call cursor.fetchAll so we can take all of our entries and print them out, or basically here, store them into the data frame. Create your column labels. which will be year, month, and the quantity of items sold. And let's see what that looks like. Sales by month, year. Okay. So you have by year, which is the first thing, and then quantity, month and quantity. But let's do some ordering. Well, how do we do that? Well, we're going to redo this. So we're going to override what we already did and say, all right, take this and then sort the sort values, and let's do it by the month first, followed by the year. And let's see what that looks like. Okay, so we first sorted by the year and then by the month. And here you notice that it didn't really matter. Okay, I did this because later when you plot, you'll notice that there's a mistake, and it will just go by the order of entry rows for the month. But then now let's convert this digit into an actual name or an abbreviation of the month. Okay, that's where this calendar import comes into play. Okay, so what I need to do is convert everything into an int, because if you notice here, when I took everything from that query, I see this double precision junk, and I'm just like, why am I getting floats, you know? And that's because of the way that it works inside of the extract. And I won't go over it. I sent a link in the bottom of the citations where you can kind of get an idea of somebody's answer on Stack Overflow of why this occurred. But anyway, let's take our sales data and let's call it something else that's pretty much similar. Let's call it month, year, capitals, and then let's take that data. And then let's do as type and then change it to int. Okay, so then now I have to do a conversion of this int to the actual month name. So we can look at what this looks like real quick if you want to make sure it actually worked and you don't trust me for it. So it worked. Okay, so we take the we need to create a new list, and we're going to call in our calendar now. All right. So we need to iterate through our sales and take only the month, and then we say let's append that data, and it's called calendar. So calendar dot, I think it's month abbreviation, yeah. Month abbreviation, and we need to do that for all of our entries. We're iterating through, so we could look at that real quick. So we see that it all prints out. Okay, perfect. Now, I say, let's create a new column. Let's create a new... What's going on with this? Let's create a new column where we call it month abbrev. I left it out the B, but who cares? Month abbreviation, and let's take it from all of our list, and then let's see what that looks like. So here's your new column corresponding to the month. Okay, cool. So we know that that works. Now we got to get our information for our plotting. So the first thing I noticed when I did this was I needed to change the plotting because it was just too small. So I figured that this worked for our example. Okay. And then I say, all right, let's take the figure and let's take the axis. And then we'll call PLT. We're going to call our subplot. And then we got to say, how big of our plot do we want? So we say the fig size equals the fig dimensions. And then you need to call the Seaborn, so I'll just alias this and you'll see why in a second. So I'm saying SNS, which is my alias for Seaborn, let's call the bar plot. And then my X will equal the year, my Y will equal the quantity, and then everything that I'm coloring will be the hue, which equals the month abbreviations. And then the data that we're using will be sales data. So then I need to do the legend, because that was extremely small when I did this before. So I said, all right, legend, we need your location to change because it went to a goofy area. And I want it to the upper right. It was in like the center before. And I also want to increase your size to 15. And then I want to set my labels, my X label as the year, the font size as 24 is what I did. And then we'll just do the same thing here. Do this for Y. Could have typed this out faster, I guess. Y, and then the quantity. Then we're gonna do this at 22. And then, you need to change these so they're bigger. These are your tickers. So we say tick parameter S. There we are. All right, cool. So now we got our plot. Perfect. So if you notice, here's our sales data. This was as of 2 days ago. One thing I would say to probably change would maybe be the color palette, so these don't blend in, or consider putting like demarcation values right here to separate each of these. Other than that, we're doing pretty good. We have it by year and by month, if you notice here, and here's our quantities of CPUs that were sold. You can do a heading or title up at the top if you want. Would be one other suggestion I would say for this. But other than that, I would like to say thank you for watching. Please subscribe and turn on that notification bell and leave a like. If you didn't like this video, throw me a comment and tell me why, so I can make this channel better for all of us. See you in the next video. Bye.